Hello, you could see me from the reflection and my phone that I'm using to record. But yeah, it was the last day I could get the free upgrade, so I decided to procrastinate. But I have to do it today because if I don't do it today, I can't show you guys what the free upgrade experience is like. All right, I think it's off. So we're gonna put this disc in. Oh, I have to actually. I should have put the disc in. Wee. Anyway. Okay. I was worried. Actually, when I put the disc in earlier, I was worried that my disc won't work because could not con oh connect it all. That worked out. I thought something was wrong with the disc. Yeah, there it is. It recognizes the DVD. But yeah. Okay, you could hear the sound, the beautiful sound of the disc drive, and the awesome Windows 7 installed disk install icon. This is how the disk actual packaging of Windows 7 used to be like, with a curvy rounded corner. Steam, you could go away. That's my friend's user account. He logged in now. It wants his password, but I'm not gonna log in with his password. But anyway, so yeah, I'm gonna use my own account because I have more games. Anyway, no, but I actually have games that I want to play versus his account, which is games that he want to play. But yeah, so I have no reason to log into his account, even if I wanted to. Anyway, even if I wanted to, I couldn't because I don't know his password. But yeah, I digress. Okay, so basically, when I put this computer back together, I made a mistake in putting the disk back properly. So I was worried I just probably damaged the disk, but thankfully it works. Alhamdulillah. So we're gonna double click to see what happens. I think the setup wizard comes. Yes. You could hear the sounds, the beautiful sounds. Oh. I'm gonna put this. So, yeah, I decided to put this disk inside to put the computer back to its factory settings. So, that is exactly what I plan to do. And then we'll use the driver disk. Oh, that's the pro disk. Where did I put the driver disk? I don't know. I think I should put the pro disk back to its place. And I think the driver disk is here. Nope, over there. Yep. But yeah. Oh, there it is. Stop hiding, you. Stop hiding, you. So I'm gonna close this. All right, there we go. Beautiful Windows 7 wallpaper. How long has it been since I've seen it? This is different. This disk I think contains all the languages, or maybe it doesn't. I actually once tried clicking a different language. It says not available or something, but I don't know. Let me see. Yeah, English. See, rather than a normal disk, when you actually put a retail disk inside the, what do you call it, in on top, when you launch a retail disk on Windows 7 disk on top of Windows, you should usually get upgrade now or install now or exit. But here you actually get a different experience. Here you get the type of keyboard US, and I think some copyright information 2009 Microsoft Corporation. Enter your language preferences and click next. I think everything looks good. I'm gonna click next, see what happens there. And check compatibility settings online. I think this website's dead, but we'll see what happens anyway. That's Microsoft Edge. Yeah, this Windows 7. Oh, it still works. Oh my god. Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor. Should we download it? Yeah, why not? Let's see. We don't want all those things. Yeah, just that. Let's click next, see what happens. I'm curious as to what'll happen. There. Two downloads in progress. Why? Oh, it had a different pack, delpack.exe. That's interesting. So it's different. The actual site is different based on the disk you use. I don't even know Microsoft had these on their website. That's interesting. So, downloads, Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor setup. Click next. I accept. Install. That is so cool. I wonder what Dell Pack is. Well, there's only one way to find out. So,
Let's see what happens. Installing. Installation complete. What do we get now? I guess we would close the browser. Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor. Yes. I wonder what it's gonna say. Windows 7. It says, check to see if your PC is ready for Windows 7. Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor checks your PC to see if it's ready to run Windows 7. When finished, you'll see which upgrade options are available and get guidance on fixing the problem, program, or device issues we found before you install Windows 7. Information about your computer will be sent back to Microsoft. However, no information will be used to identify or contact you. For more information, read our privacy policy. Remember the days when Microsoft didn't collect personal information like they do in Windows 10? Yep, I remember those days too. Start check. This will take a few minutes, checking compatibility. Now, what we're going to do is I'm going to install the Dell pack now while this happens. See what that is all about. Yep, I bought SimCity 3000 from GOG. And we could clear out Nainite Steam installer. I don't need that right now. I installed Steam with it. Yes. Okay, so number of issues you may need to address. Custom installation required. You'll need to perform a custom installation of 64-bit Windows 7 and reinstall the programs. Yeah, because I'm running Windows 10. Duh. Can't upgrade from Windows 10 to 7. That makes no sense. I don't think setup has a downgrade option either, because Microsoft would need to be a psychic and would need to know what future versions of Windows Server looked like. Anyway, more info from Dell Incorporated. Dell has a website that might give you more information about getting Windows 7 running on your PC. So, all system requirements passed. See system requirements. Our devices, Realtek PCIe family controller that has, before installing Windows 7, go to device manufacturer website, download the latest drivers. After installing Windows 7, save the drivers. Ooh. Microsoft Print to PDF, we don't have compatible information about this device. And XPS document writer, before these are later, these are newer version of drivers came with Windows 10, so of course Windows 7 doesn't know it. The graphics drivers compatible. Six devices are listed compatible. See all devices. Two programs that says compatible. Oh, which programs does it recognize all these years? Remember, this is a 2009 software, so. Oh, okay. Okay, it recognizes Rosetta Stone, which I have, because it's an older program. But yeah, it recognizes this program itself. So it recognizes itself and Rosetta Stone. It doesn't even recognize everything else. So let's see what happens if I click System Requirements. So CPU 2.1 GHz, 7.9 GB of RAM. My PC meets the minimum 2 gig RAM requirements, 1 GHz processor requirement, 76.7 GB of disk space. It meets the minimum requirement of 20 hard disk space. Okay, more information from Dell Incorporated. Let's see what happens, which website it takes me to if I click this. Windows 7 support on Dell. So yeah, even Dell has the Windows 7 support on the website. So I guess that's useful. I guess this thing is still useful for someone who wants to reinstall Windows 7 all these years later, even though it's an older program and might not function properly, especially with new software it won't recognize. But yeah. So let's close that and see what the Dell pack is all about. Yeah, and I downloaded SimCity here. And another SimCity 3000, one of my favorite favorite in my series. I haven't played SimCity 4 too much, but I did play a little, but I still prefer SimCity 3000 because it has awesome advising system. Oh, there it is in the bottom. Oh, no, that's not it. That's the installer. The Dell pack does nothing, apparently. Anyway, I guess we could just run the setup. Install now. See what we get. We might need to install Dell pack after we install Windows 7. I'll give that another whirl after we install Windows 7. So, yeah, I click install now so you can go back to the factory setting. And for those of you who are asking, oh no, we should boot from the disk. Who cares? I want to make life easier, so I'm not going to boot from the disk unless I have to. Setup is copying temporary files. Yeah, I just plugged the CD in and started setup. Don't need to boot it from the disk and format the drive, because I have files in there I don't want to lose. So
Also, I also made a virtual copy of the disk, an ISO, and had I lost this CD or damaged this disk, and had I not made the virtual disk, I'd be screwed. I'd actually be in trouble because I haven't written down the product code, and as you saw earlier, the sticker on the back is also destroyed or damaged, so I can't retrieve the key from there. So if I didn't have this real or virtual disk that I made a backup of, ouch. The following issues are preventing from Windows from upgrading. Cancel the upgrade. Complete each. Windows cannot be installed when the computer is in battery power. Okay, so I have to actually get rid of. Oh, plug it in. Can't believe I made the mistake. Okay. Give me a second while I plug in the disk. Yes, cancel setup. Plug it in to the disk. Or plug in the sock. Plug in the plug to the socket. And then plug in the computer to the plug. Or charger or adapter, whatever you call it. Okay. And there. Yep. There. Now you're plugged in. How much battery did I lose anyway? Back in the day, a 2-hour battery was a standard back in those days. Okay. 48%. Yeah, that means I would only last less than an hour, because 48% might seem like a lot today, but back in the day, that's like less than an hour, because the battery itself at 100% lasted only 2 hours. So install now. Again, so yeah. So we're going to be doing that. So, had I not made a... Hey, Nemo, want to say hi? Yeah, there you go, buddy. Small fin, big fin. Oh, it's done. Do you see that, Nemo? Yeah. We're going to get latest and more information. Let's see if it downloads additional information. Searching for downloading installation updates. See, there's another advantage of not booting from the disk. You get a more patched version of the setup. So, yeah. See, also, it didn't ask me for a product key. As I said, this disk is a little different. It's not... Oh, what is this? No. It couldn't get installation from the update. It couldn't get the update. So I guess we're gonna... I take everything back about getting the updates. In general, had the upgrade worked, or update worked, I would have had a more patched setup. But in this case, it makes no difference. So I'll choose no. Also I wanna help make Windows better. So I'll check this. Remember, back in the day, they didn't collect personal information. They collected telemetry, but today, unlike today, in Windows 10, they do collect personal information. So remember that. Windows 7 Home Premium, software license term. Just notice that it did not ask me for a product key. Can't do upgrade, I have to do custom. This is where Windows 10 is installed. OEM reserved, system reserved, we'll just click next. The partition you selected might contain files from a previous Windows version, or previous Windows installation, which is the case, I have Windows 10. If it does, then the files in the folders will be removed to a folder named Windows.old. You will be able to access information on Windows.old, but you will not be able to use your previous version of Windows. This changes in Windows 10, where you can roll back to a previous version of Windows, but even if this was Windows 10, you can't roll back if you downgrade. So, okay. So now it is copying files. Ah, the arrow theme looked pretty nice. The glass theme here. Installing Windows. This is all the information we need right now. Your computer will restart several times during installation. Copying Windows files, 0%. Now, let's talk about the specs. You saw a little bit of the specs earlier. This has a 4 gigs of RAM. Back when I bought this computer, I did decide to... I pushed my dad to get me a 4 gig RAM laptop because I knew back in the day, 2 gigs were standard. But back in the day, 4 gigs seemed overkill for regular use, but today it's like the minimum. But I knew if I wanted to last 4 to 5 years, I needed more than 2 gigs. And I want to get a 64-bit OS and have 4 gigs on it and make use of it. Also, I had 256 gigabyte of 5400 RPM hard drive. It seemed great to me, but today I realize how slow that is. I also had an Intel. I also wanted to make sure that I got an Intel Core series. This is the first generation of Intel Core i3. Intel just came out with their revolutionary new processors, the Intel Core i series processors. Core i3, Core i5, Core i7. Those are new, those are all hyped. I was so excited because it had the Intel HD graphics. I did not have enough money. Our budget did not allow for a graphics card to laptop, for a laptop to have a dedicated graphics card. So I had to get the HD graphics, Intel HD graphics. That was the best integrated CPU, GPU could find at the time, and I wanted to do as much as get, I wanted to be able to take advantage of the best graphics at the price, and I had to get a Core i series. i3 was the cheapest, but I still got the HD graphics. I was so happy. Westmere, until the next year when the Sandy Bridge came out and it had proper double the graphics performance, I think. And Ivy Bridge came out, it offered even greater graphics performance than Sandy Bridge. Today we have Haswell, and now we also had Broadwell. Now we're on Skylake with Kaby Lake, Intel Kaby Lake, the 6th generation Core i series processors coming out later this year. But back then it was, I was so excited, and I think, alhamdulillah, with Allah's help, and I made the right choice. This processor combined with the RAM has given me enough, allowed me to use this laptop for more than 5 years, 6 years actually, more than 6 years. And I am very grateful for this. And I did eventually, a year and a half ago, replace the hard drive with an SSD. And that's only because I dropped something on this computer, and actually I think it dropped this computer and it destroyed the hard drive. So I'm glad SSD made a huge difference. I also upgraded the RAM after from 4 GB to 8 GB, as you saw earlier on the Windows 7 Upgrade Advisor. It's at 7.9 gigs or something of RAM. But yeah, so we're at 21% of copying Windows files, and I did not have to boot from the disk, so I didn't have to change the BIOS order. Awesome. So there you go. We'll come back when this is done, and we're gonna get to the next step, which is installing the drivers and updating the drivers, I think. So I am on my Surface here, and I'm downloading all the updates for Windows 7. So when Windows 7 is done installing on that computer, I could update them offline without having to worry about, you know, manually downloading them, which will be a pain in the butt. So I'm downloading the Surface Pack and cumulative updates till to bring Windows 7 up to date till April 2016, which will still require 2 more months of updates. And an update for the GWX Windows or Get Windows 10 control panel, which will let me upgrade to Windows 10. The version of Windows that comes on the disk, and I wanted to do it for the sake of, I wanted to get all the Dell drivers and get the proper licensing. I have to install Windows 10, 7 RTM, so no service pack. So I have to do that, and I think that install is almost done. Let's go check. All right, let's see. So we have trying to door off. So we have Windows 7. Yeah, I remember back in the day, this part, completing setup or completing installation, took a long time. Copying Windows file takes a while. If you're booting from the disk, it's done instantly. But if you run it from within Windows, copying Windows file takes a while, as you saw before I paused the video, it was copying Windows file. Expanding Windows file takes the most longest because this is the actual part that's actually installing the OS. And installing feature, installing updates. Those are features update. It's finished it within seconds. It doesn't even have any, I mean, noticeable time differences. But in the days of Windows, I remember completing installation took a long time. And by the way, it actually rebooted after it finished copying Windows file. To expand the Windows file, it rebooted, so it's Windows 10 is gone, it's moved aside, and actually did the installing, and again, setup will restart after, so yeah, thankfully, it was in the copying Windows file for, completing the setup phase for a long time, Dell Inspiron, and we'll see the beautiful Windows 7 logo, Windows 7 starting logo, but yeah, but today in Windows 10, the completing setup takes almost no time at all, it gets done immediately, but there's a lot of getting ready after that, but yeah. Let's remember what Windows 7 setup was like, because I think from now we'll see it. Yep, special setup is preparing your computer for the first use. So there's a nice aura effect. The effect is a continuation from the Vista days. Windows Vista, this part was different. It had some awesome slideshows with pictures, slideshows and pictures of different things you could do with Windows, just like those of Windows XP. But in Windows XP's case, and 98's case, and Millennium's case, the talk or the slideshow happened during install, whereas in Vista it happened during that video setting video card configuration phase. And Windows 7 there's just Aura, and Windows 10 there's nothing. It's just like Windows 8, it's just getting ready. So it's very boring, Windows 10. So this part is the setting up Windows part. This is the part where, this is exactly what you saw when I first purchased Dell PC. This is what I got, but it had more crapware built into it. But this is what I got at first. Type in a username and it'll type a computer name. By default, it's PC, but watch what it does. So I'm going to type in Nasmus. NAZMUS. Nasmus, and it automatically put in Nasmus-PC for it. There's some accessibility options. Copyright 2009 Microsoft Corporation. Remember, this is Windows 7 RTM. This is Windows 7 exactly as it came out with no patches in 2009. This was sent to OEMs back in August of 2009. So it's like 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. That is 7 years ago. So this, I just installed a 7 years old OS, and I'll inshallah upgrade this to a modern operating system that's only a few months old, which will also get updated in a couple of days to the anniversary update, which is only a few weeks old. So yeah, a lot of updates. Type in a password. So I'll type in a password, I'll be back. Anyway, so I typed in a password and this hint is standard, because I have a standard password in my brain. So how to protect your help protect your computer from and improve Windows automatically. I'm actually going to ask me later. I will keep Windows Update off because I want to install all the updates offline. I don't want it to start fetching updates. It'll just waste time. So I'm going to turn Update off and turn back on when I have Windows 7 up to date with all the offline updates. So I'm not at Pacific time, I'm at Central time. So there it is, Central time, US and Canada. And date is correct, July 29th, 2016. This is the last day to get the free upgrade, so hopefully I'll be able to get Windows 7 up to date and get the GWX control panel and begin the upgrade before it's too late. So click next. And again, I have already licensed this computer with Windows 10, so even if I fail, I'll not be stuck. So give me a second while I type this password in. The Wi-Fi, the old style of old way of doing Wi-Fi, but I like it had an animation. Not a lot of back in the day OSs, including Windows, had animation. So Windows only had animation for a few parts, and this is one of the few parts. So yeah, I'll be back in a bit. All right, this is a feature that I miss. Windows 10 no longer asks you this. You could set up it as a home network or work network or public network immediately within setup. So you don't have to do it after the fact. I like that. So I'll set this up as a home network. Connecting to your network and applying settings. Awesome. Let's see what happens. We'll be back in a bit. I'll be back. All right. It's actually finished doing the configuration. It's at Windows 7 Home Premium. And then it went to this screen. So it's preparing your desktop. This is where the equivalent for this in Windows 10 is, hi, we're getting things ready for you. You could get new apps in the store, blah, blah, blah. And then it says, let's start. So this is the Windows 7 equivalent of that annoying wait period you have to do when it provisions a user account. So yep, so we'll have to wait in a bit. In Windows XP, you saw a small dialog box here, and sometimes some configuration here in workplaces. In work professional versions of Windows, where group policy requires more verbose login. But yeah, as you can see, I have no graphics driver installed either. I have Wi-Fi, I have internet. Unfortunately, I also have Internet Explorer 8, which needs to be gotten rid of quickly. So before that, it's time to see Internet Explorer 8, Windows Media Player. Let's configure everything. Let's see if internet connection. So at least the Wi-Fi driver comes out of the box for this device. Next. Do not turn on suggested sites. Next. Use Express setting. Search provider Bing. Finish. Yes. Let's see what it says. Does it say my browser's out of date? We'll find out. Back in the day it says, yay, you updated your browser. Good job. Ooh, already a security warning. Okay.
Which is funny because back in the day it says, yay, you updated your browser. But the funny thing is, Windows 7, this is the retail RTM version of Windows 7. So it's kind of funny to see, oh, you updated your browser. Because if when it's actually the stock browser that comes with the OS with no updates attached. I think there's like no updates. I think there's the RTM version of the browser. Let's go to help about Internet Explorer. It's not even loading the site. 8.0.7.6.16385. I think there's one update because I think the stock browser that comes with the OS is OS version is 16.384. So it's like has one update, 16.385. So yeah, it is basically stock. Again, this is the thing that came out. This is the pure vanilla RTM version of the OS. I don't think the site is loading. So yeah, this is the vanilla version of Windows 10, Windows 7, with no crapware. One thing I liked about Dell is that it had no crapware. It had some, like, a couple of unwanted software and some software I did use, like McAfee back in the day. I thought it was actually a good software. I used it. Now I no longer use Antivirus. Except the one that comes with Windows. Back in the day, Windows didn't come with antivirus, and so I used McAfee security software, and it had, I think, a DVD player, but I don't think it had any other crapware. I liked it. That's one thing I liked about Dell. Back in the day, HP was terrible. Now they're really good. HP had a lot of crapware back in the day, but now I think HP is doing great, even though computers still have crapware today. But this computer didn't, and the disk they gave me is purely vanilla Windows 7 disk. Sometimes the recovery disk have all bloated software in it, but this is pure recovery disk, like pure vanilla. I'm so glad that's the case. So let's see, view basic information about your computer, Windows 7 Home Premium, not even no service pack as you can see, get more feature with the new edition of Windows. So this is a Windows 7 Anytime Upgrade. Ooh, look at this. Yeah, Windows Anytime Upgrade with Windows logo and stuff. Go online to the edition of Windows, enter upgrade key. So yeah, so that's pretty cool. I'm gonna close this. I don't need Pro. My mom doesn't need Pro. But one thing you get by using this disk versus a vanilla disk is you get this Dell logo here. So that's pretty cool. You get this Dell logo here, and so rating, system rating not available. We'll rate it after you upgrade the GPU or upgrade. And so the graphics driver, Intel Core i3 CPU, M330, 2.13 GHz, 3.13 GHz for both processors, a dual core processor, install memory, 8 GB, 7.8 GB usable, 64-bit operating system, no pen and touch info available for this device. This is the first version of Windows that supported multi-touch, so that's good. But yeah, so it's time to install the drivers. See you in a bit. Let's get started. Okay. Yeah, I put that disk. I think we could take the disk out and put this back in it. Since I'll probably never use Windows 8 Pro, the disk, because there's 8.1, if I need to do that, I don't think I'll use this disk anymore. But I also have a virtual ISO, so I'll probably use that. So I'll put this Windows 7 disk in case I ever need to go back to Windows 7. And since I don't have the key, I need this disk or ISO version of it, which I made. I'm going to put this on top so I don't get confused. And as I said, I probably never will look. Again, I said probably will never look for the offline version of Windows 8 disk. Maybe I will. That's why I keep it. So it's time to take the. I cleaned everything up. It's time to. I put the driver on top. One thing I found funny about one of the older other disks is the printer disk. Yep, this one. Yeah, it's like. Wow, this is the Windows 7. This has like a giant Windows 7 on it, which makes no sense. Brother, it's actually a driver, but it's kind of like, oh, Windows 7, come to the PC. No, actually, that's, if someone's going to quickly steal my disks, and they'll probably take this one first because they'll be full. Oh, Windows 7, there it is. They make it so easy to identify. Yep, this is Windows 7. Small Windows 7 Home Premium. Okay. The color of the disk depends on the edition. So I think green is pre-home premium. Blue is home base. No, blue is professional, home basic. I think it's black. I don't know. That's a similar thing with Vista. Vista home premium was navy blue, and my older laptop. And Vista home basic was, I think, black. So I'll show you that in a later video. Inshallah. So here. Whoa, there it is. Almost touched the back. It got very clean for the age. So I'm going to install the drivers. Hello. Uh-oh. No. There. I was getting worried for a little bit. I think I did damage the drive at least a little bit. Never had this issue. Or maybe it's... Maybe I double-pressed the thing, causing it to... I don't know what I did. There. No. Won't accept it. Did I destroy this drive? Okay, this worked this time. Windows/E. There. No animation, no arrow, because there's no graphics driver installed. If I click on screen resolution here, I'm running at a lower resolution of 800 by 600. If your resolution is below 1024 by 768, some has been on for the screen, but I can go back to 1024 by 768. I can go back to 1024 by 768, but at this point I won't, because I'm going to run the driver setup first. So let's do that. There's no sound. There is sound driver. Let's see if sound plays. Yep, sound plays perfectly. Strangely, it's at 63%. I don't know why. So this is they used to come with a disc. The Dell Resource CD is about to begin the installation routine. Okay, I guess.
I could hear the sounds.
Ooh, different user account sounds. Awesome. Yes. Preparing to install. Dell Resource CD is preparing setup. There's a Windows installer MSI. Next. Oh. Next. Install. I'll definitely need to get Firefox or something, because I am not using Internet Explorer. Not at this point, actually. But I'll also update Internet Explorer as well, so at least we have some usable browser before. Because IE8 is unusable today, because that's a 7-year-old browser using internet, modern internet. Has no HTML5 support. It is a painful browser to use. IE6 is unusable. It doesn't even work anymore, but IE8 works, but it's very painful. Okay, let's see what we got here. Welcome, Dell System Owner. Next, click here to begin this. Next. So Inspiron 1604, Windows 7 64-bit, it detected my system. So, what is this? Topic, my system. Okay, all to device utility driver. So we have, let's see, it detects that audio driver is installed, and Intel chipset, the CPU driver is installed. But all these other drivers are not yet installed, so we might need to reinstall those anyway, just to be safe. But I'm going to install a newer version later on. Alps touchpad, I need a touchpad driver actually, because touchpad is not doing what I wanted to do. It's not very responsive, and it is not, letting me scroll with the scroll gestures. Extract files, click to extract the files. Continue. Okay. Yes, please. All files are extracted. Next. Please wait while the driver installs. Updated. Restart now, I guess. Oh, the shutdown sound. I forgot this sound for a long time. Now, next part is the graphics driver. Be right back.
Ah, the Windows logo. The shining, beautiful login screen that I missed from Windows 10. Or miss in Windows 10. I wish Windows 10 had an awesome, like, aura animation with the new Windows logo, like, in the desktop background. Because they use... and the username. Wow, I forgot all this. And the sound. So, I'll be back.
Okay. No animation to boot up Explorer. Let's see. I hope it doesn't ask me to install it, because otherwise I'll have to launch it from the hard drive. I hope it recognizes that it already installed it. Will it not work? Oh. It found it. Okay. So audio driver, chipset driver. As you can see, my touchpad driver is there. I could like scroll it and the
Driver's there, awesome. I could like, I'm gonna enable something because I always use it. So there's the touch pedal. It also shows a heat map or how hard or where I'm tapping. So there, I'm gonna enable some gestures. Enable circle scrolling. So that'll allow me to continue scrolling. Oh, like that. Oh, I have to apply first. Whoa, I can't see anything now because the resolution is too slow or too low. Let me just improve the resolution first because I think it's getting cut off. Screen resolution 1024 by 768. Okay. There. Yes, keep the changes. Okay, now I can see. So I have to apply this. Now I could scroll. So like this allows me to spin the trackpad and continue scrolling. Yep. So I'm gonna close this. Close that and go back to this. Time to install the graphics driver. Why not, right? So let's see. Communication, all these are not installed, man. Dell wireless driver, yep. Network driver, Ethernet controls installed. But it should put a check on the wireless driver because I do have internet network. It definitely does not have video driver installed. So I think this is not detecting things properly, but I will definitely install the video driver. Definitely need that. Extract. Yes, please. Time to get some Windows Aero back. Created. Yep, it wants to create. It's extracting all these installers on my C drive. What did I click yes to? So yeah, there's a license agreement. Yep. Next. We're installing the video and you'll see some flashes. Fun stuff. Version 8.15, 8.15.10. Installing driver, installing graphics mirror accelerator, graphics meter accelerator 8.15, 8.15, and graphics display audio 6.12. Copying files, click to continue. Yes, restart the computer now. Alright, I think, as you can see, it looks, hopefully, it looks like a higher resolution, but I'm not sure if it's high enough. We'll see if we got Aero now that I installed the graphics driver. It says welcome, so, and welcome sign looks a little smaller, a lot smaller. So hopefully that's a good sign, but let's find out. There's my thumbs up right there. Yay, look at this! You have Aero, so you have the graphics driver. Thing with Windows 8 and 10 is that Aero or desktop composition or DWM is always enabled. So as you can see, we have Aero here. So finish. Windows Media Player. Awesome. Well and dandy. And Explorer. And you can see all these window popping up animation. That means things are working. We have device driver for the graphics card. Now let's install some additional drivers, and then we can do the updates. So there's some drivers for devices that is not included in my hardware. Turbo Boost technology do not need it because it only works with Intel Core i5. TV receiver, I don't have a TV tuner, I don't know what that is. GRE6 update, oh, Java runtime, definitely don't want that. I'm not having Java on my device. I forgot the name of my wireless card. I'll check my device driver for that. Diagnostics. This I do want. Dell QuickSet, I think, application driver. I'll install that. Rev AO3. Extract. Do I need it? No, I don't need it. It actually did a. It actually does sound up and down thing, but Windows 10. Already has that. It also has a check for battery, but I think Windows 10 has a device like that. And Dell Support Center. I don't think I need that either.
So there's that. Because this device, this PC is out of support, so we could ignore those two. Let's see. So yeah, we have. I don't need the Dell. What is it? Webcam software, because I might need it. I might need the audio for the webcam. We never know. MS Inbox. Oh, it uses the MS Inbox driver. So it also uses the Microsoft Inbox driver. So I'm not actually getting any drivers with this. So I don't need the software, because Windows 10 comes with the camera app. So that's no longer necessary. So yeah, I think it got everything from the disk. I have some additional drivers I'll install. An updated version of the graphics driver. I'll install an updated version of the sound driver. And see if my touchpad drivers has any update. Other than that, I think I'm good. Maybe a Wi-Fi driver? Well, let's see. Let me see what wireless driver I have. So I'm going to right-click on computer. I'm tempted to right-click here. Like in Windows 10, you get advanced utilities. But that's not the case. In 7, you have to actually click here and click manage. Manage. And then you could see your device manager right there. And device manager. Wireless. Network drivers or network adapters. Wireless 1397 WLAN mini card. So I think I know what driver this is. $1502 mini card driver, so half mini card, so $1520. This is $1520. I totally forgot the number for that. Oh man, manage. So let's go to device manager, network adapters, other devices, PCI simple communications controller. I think I need that. There's a question mark here. 1397, so I actually need a updated driver. I think 1397 is smaller than 1502, I think. So 1520, same as is it the same card? I don't know. Initial release, so it's not even an update, so it might be a different card. So I don't think I need that driver, so I'm gonna go back. Where it said PCI what? It required a communication utilities, Ethernet, USB modem utility. Let me try that again. Let me try going to computer, manage, see if I could find a driver from the disk. Device manager and driver, update driver, browse my computer. Let's do the disk. Let's do the disk drive. Let's see what happens. Next. Nope, I don't think it works that way, because everything needs to be extracted. So that's yeah, because I remember, not the driver is not on the disk, it's actually extracted, that needs to be extracted to the C drive. Simple communication controller, so that is I have no idea. Let's see, what, how about the audio, audio or sound and video controller. High definition audio device. Is this Realtek? Yeah, driver date 7/13/2009. I might have a new driver with me that I downloaded. So yeah, I think the rest of the drivers I will download, and I think we're good. So now time to update Windows. Oh, and one more thing. I thought this was black. It's not black. This disk is gray. I have a Windows 7 Home Basic disk that's black, and Home Premium disk that's navy blue. But this is gray, not black. Looked black earlier, but yeah, cool. See ya. Alright everyone, I finished downloading all the updates, and I'm going to open my USB drive. It has my Windows 7, the same disk on my USB. I copied it there just in case for some reason the disk didn't work.
So I have Windows 7 update. Let's see. This is my drivers, but first I'll update some stuff. Let's do service pack, because this does not have service pack. So WinVir. If I open WinVir, as you can see, it's Windows 7, build 7600. 7600, this means the service pack was 7601. So I need to install service pack 1. So I think this is service pack 1. Windows 6.1. That's not service pack 1. This is service pack 1. Oh no. This Windows 7. Oh, I hate Windows 7.